hakuna hata kitu chochote.
Kenya on Sunday began 3 days of national mourning for the 148 people, mostly students, massacred by Somalia's Shabab militants at a university in Garissa. Easter church services throughout the country included prayers for the victims of Thursday's attack, with flags also at half-mast. Although President Uhuru Kenyatta has vowed to retaliate in the severest way possible, there have also been calls for national unity. Kenyatta said people's justified anger should not lead to victimization of anyone, a clear reference to Kenya's large Muslim and ethnic Somali minorities. Authorities, meanwhile, announced that they had identified one of the 4 dead Shabab gunmen as an ethnic Somali and Kenyan national who was an A-grade pupil and law graduate, highlighting the Al-Qaeda-linked Shabab's ability to recruit within Kenya. The Interior Ministry spokesman Mwenda Njoka said it was critical that parents whose children go missing or show tendencies of having been exposed to violent extremism report to authorities. The militants attacked the university at dawn and lined up non-Muslim students for execution in what Kenyatta described as a barbaric medieval slaughter.
The terrorists attacked the university and she is under the bed, hiding in the bed. So we had a communication that the child was under the bed. And with my hope, in quotes there, I think the child is still alive. And it might be within the university.
The massacre, Kenya's deadliest attack since the 1998 bombing of the U.S. Embassy in Nairobi, claimed the lives of 142 students, 3 police officers, and 3 soldiers. The top Muslim leader, Hassan Ole Nado, also offered his condolences. Political and religious leaders have condemned the attacks. Pope Francis called the killings senseless brutality, while the Cairo-based top Sunni Muslim body, Al-Azhar, has condemned the terrorist act committed by Somalia's Shabab.